shows your picture on those intersections. Many of our most basic structures and fundamental structures rest on threes. The three is the most beginning member of community, of family. When a husband and wife are married together, they are a couple, but when they have a child, there are three. And the couple becomes a family. And so it's today, it's rather fascinating to think about the story of the Transfiguration and see all the threes. Jesus calls three disciples, Peter and James and John, to go up with him on a high mountain. Maybe Jesus kind of knew what he was doing about. It sounds a lot like the Marines, doesn't it? I've often wondered why Jesus didn't take all 12. And what about the other nine that were left behind? But maybe Jesus knew that it was only three that he could really watch and take care of. Or maybe those were sent back to form units of four. Three units of four, 12 disciples. There's still more. Jesus was transfigured before them, and his face shone like the sun, and his clothes became dazzling white, and suddenly we have threes. Jesus and Moses and Elijah talking with him. And on that mountaintop, the three disciples beheld three persons. Jesus, transfigured in all his glory, and beside him were two of the greatest figures in Israel's history, Moses representing the law and Elijah representing the prophets. In other words, Jesus was the fulfillment of everything, all the history of God's people that had come before him. It's only when the three disciples are gathered together behold the glory and the wonder of Jesus. What is this saying to us? Christianity is community. Jesus comes into community. For too long, we have understood our relationship with God to be singular. Decision to theology, making a decision for Jesus, has influenced us in many profound ways. And you combine that with American individualism, and it's hard for us to think otherwise. We tend to like statements like, oh, it's just you and me, God, or it's just you and me, Jesus, or I have decided to follow Jesus. Jesus didn't call just one. Jesus called 12. Community. He first formed a community. Christianity is not a religion of the individual, of one person receiving the divine truth, or of one person giving their life to Jesus, or one person rising through different levels of holiness. Christianity is when two or three come together in my name. That is the promise of Jesus. Then I will be with you. It is there in the calling together of community that Jesus comes. It's when the disciples are together that they see Jesus transfigured. It is when Jesus is with Moses and Elijah that the full extent of the glory of Jesus is revealed, and he is transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became dazzling white. Today you are doing a good thing, brothers in Christ, sisters in Christ. You are doing a good thing. You are not alone. It's a holy thing to come together, to see Jesus, to behold Jesus, to receive Jesus. You have come together to that place where Jesus has promised to be, where two or three are gathered. You're not home alone. watching television or sitting in front of a computer screen or checking your cell phone out and trying to receive God, make contact with God in that way. No, you have chosen to be with the people of God. To take time out from your busy daily lives to be community. To behold Jesus transfigured among us in all of his glory. And linked together by the power of the Holy Spirit, we sing and we pray, open our eyes, Lord. We want to see Jesus. It's not open my eyes, Lord. I want to see Jesus, but open our eyes, Lord. We want to see Jesus. And so I pray that this day, that God answers that prayer for you. In the Word, Jesus comes to us. In the bread and the wine, Jesus comes to us. In the community of saints and sinners that are gathered together, Jesus comes to us this day. And today we behold his glory. And yet, here's another good thing, good news for you, that this is not the end of the story. For Jesus didn't stay up there on the mountain with Moses and Elijah having a grand old time, but Jesus went down the mountain with the disciples. Down the mountain with those that he had promised. Went down the mountain with those whom said, I will be with you always. Went down the mountain into daily life, filled with all of the challenges and the struggles and valleys that we face. Jesus walked with them, and Jesus walks with you. So as you leave this place, know that Jesus is with you as you go on your way, giving you strength and courage and faith to face whatever comes on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And we get to do it all over again and behold his glory when we come together. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, we'll keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. There our hymn of the day, please stand. With the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Lord God, we thank you for revealing to us who Jesus truly is. We pray that as we behold his glory, that we might not keep it to ourselves, but that we would share it with others. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, we pray for the church throughout the world. We pray for the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America and our presiding bishop, Elizabeth Heaton. We pray for our missionaries, Dr. Stephen and Bethany Freiberg in Tanzania, as they seek to bring healing. We pray for our partner synod, the Lutheran Church of Nigeria, and Naomi Zachariah, one of the girls who is still being held by Boko Haram. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus, we pray that you would walk with those who are ill in any way, shape, or form. Bring your healing hand to Dennis, and to all that we know, friends and relatives, loved ones who are struggling with illness or disease. Bring your healing hand upon them. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for those from our congregation who continue to serve our country in the military. Be with Doug and Alex and Brad and Ryan and Kyle and Billy and Scott and Justin and Kaylee and Scott. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we thank you that we can gather as a congregation, that we come together as your followers, as Peter and James and John did long ago. Reveal to us the glory of your Son, that Jesus is not just an ordinary human being or just a teacher, but is the true Son of God, holy in majesty, one who is name above all names, Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. During this flu season, we won't shake hands, but we do touch each other on the shoulder or on the arm. Let's share that peace of the Lord with one another. We joyfully share our gifts with the Lord. Thank you. Please stand for the offering prayer. We pray together. Merciful God, as grains of wheat scattered upon the hills were gathered together to become one bread, so let your church be gathered together from the ends of the earth into your glory. For yours is the glory through Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the banquet, for all is now ready. Those who believe in Christ as their Lord and Savior are welcome to join us at the altar. There's room for more.
Savior, I come, quiet my soul. Redemption's here, where let us fill your answer. Everything I once held dear, I count it all as loss. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me. Lead me to the cross. You were as I, tempted and tried. Sin and death. Now you're risen. Everything I once held dear, I count it all as lost. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong. To the cross where your love.
Please stand. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. God of abundance, with this bread of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. We sing our sending song. Worship is over. Our ministry has just begun. Go in peace. Share the good news.